Okay, cool. Welcome back here. Remember last time we had my very special surprise mystery guest star, Gustavius, helping me remove all these trees along there, along that field there. Eventually, we'll get all those ones out too. But it's actually the same game day as the last episode. I've just removed this last one of these stumps here, just so once this extra bit here is plowed, the harvesters and stuff, they have a bit more room to turn around. I'll just turn the lights off because I don't know if that actually damages it or not. But yeah, even though I was sort of duped a bit, like leasing sort of the wrong equipment and stuff, I'm gonna have to go up here and turn around. Yeah, even though I goofed a bit, like leasing some of the wrong equipment and, you know, a bit of a fail with the wheel loader and that. It was a bit hard to use. So. Yeah, even with all that, even with all that money spent doing that, we're still up about 50 grand. And that was probably, I don't know, a dozen trees, 14 trees or something. And we've still got like one more, or almost a full trailer load of wood chips to sell too. So I'll just take this back and then I'll go and sell that last trailer load of wood chips. I wouldn't actually mind buying one of these. These wood chipper things, though, they're quite cool. Well, it saves a lot of the farting around of loading all the logs onto a trailer. And I'm not actually sure if you get more or less money selling wood chips or logs. Probably, you'd probably get more with logs, but it'd be a hell of a lot less hassle doing it with wood chips. So you could use my skid steer loader, I guess, to load reasonable size logs into here and do them probably half a tree at a time or something, rather than using that little logging trailer. But yeah, we'll return this because this is still costing some money. Yeah, return it around here. Yeah, I'm glad I figured out where to take these back to. That, jump out. We'll just check what was our least vehicle costs. 28,000. Now a lot of that was probably duping around with the loader and the trailer and the other chipper and all that stuff. So yeah, well, I'll know what to use next time, eh? So it'll be a lot cheaper. Now we'll just jump to this guy and we'll take this stuff down to sell, and we'll know sort of roughly how much we've made. I think we started. Started with 100,000, I think, at the start of the last episode. That was actually after I'd leased the loader and the trailer, and the log fork, of course. So yeah, we're up about 50 grand, I guess, which isn't bad. Yeah, well, more like probably 30, I guess, or 25 grand. Yeah, but yeah, I guess wood chips are lucrative enough to make it worthwhile. I mean, like, there's trees everywhere, and there is that placeable. I've got a little bit of lag there. There is that placeable. The heating plant. It costs 68,000, but you could just drop wood chips straight in there. Well, there's this here. Any logs immediately sold to the water. I'm not sure which one earns more money, but like that one, this heating plant might be right, because you could probably stick that, hold on, while I talk, I'll turn my tractor off, because you could probably stick that like nearby the big logging place, like maybe up here, and have a wood chipper like feeding into it, and just keep putting the logs in. Or like conveyor belts to, you know, drive a truck up and just like dump a whole lot off, you know. Well, that might be right, eh? Wee. Yeah. So through the night, I think what I'll do is I'll just organise my vehicles a bit better, because they're sort of scattered all around the wilderness at the moment. Yeah, organise my vehicles, get ready for the next harvest. Don't cut me off. Speaking of cutting a corner, yeah, I'll organise my vehicles, wait for the harvest and sort of plan about what the next step is. Like I quite like to extend that field into the spot. Oh, can I shoot the gap into that? Sorry about your paintwork. Yeah, quite like to extend that field into that bit where we removed the trees in the last episode. Because I could probably get, I don't know, two more rows there, maybe one and a half more rows. Yeah, when harvest time comes around, I mean, we'll earn a little bit more money off that. I mean, even, you know, we'll even earn a bit of money just clearing that ground, you know. Yeah, like I said, you'd probably earn more from the logs than the wood chips. But I think it's less hassle doing the wood chips than it is the logs. Because you saw how much, like, we were sort of struggling to dump the logs in the right places and stuff. To get them on the trailer and actually pick them up and stuff, so. I think maybe wood chips are the way to go. Alright then. I'll pause it here and I'll bring you back around about harvest time, so you'll see you soon. Okay, cool, welcome back. Yeah, I've got all my vehicles all organised. Now, I've got this guy here because I noticed the price for wheat at Gomez Ridge Acres is actually really high, $8.31. Now, I will have to drive all the way down there, but that's alright, we'll fill this guy up. We don't quite have a full trailer yet. But, oh yeah, I had this guy down here filling up the manure for the greenhouses because they're actually empty. I had my harvester on this field here, which is actually planted in wheat. Now he's ready to harvest that. Yeah, just in case, like, I could harvest this before the price, you know, sort of stabilised and started going down again. That guy's not doing anything particular. Now I've got this guy here, he's going to buy a pallet fork. I'll tell you why in a second. Pallet fork. Because I also noticed the price of wool is really high too, and I think we've got 4 bales of that. So that's 16,000 per bale. So we'll take him down. We'll take him down to the sheep in a second. Actually, we'll do the truck first. Put the cover on. Yeah, sorry about how dark it is. I'll have to remember to brighten this up in post so you can actually see what's going on. But you will take this dude down, that should give us a few chunk of money. Oh yeah, that's right, I have my trailer parked there. My other trailer. See, I was just going to run all the wheat from that field there into the silo with that and then fill this up and then make a whole bucket load of money. But yeah, I guess, yeah, this trailer worth will be enough. It'll be enough to get us going for our next stage, which I'll tell you about in a second. Yeah, so after I take this guy down to dump off his grain, I'll take the tractor that I've got parked by the shop with the pallet fork up to load the rest of the wool onto that trailer and take it down and sell it. Then I'll take that guy with his pallet fork back to the shop again to buy some seedling pellets, because that field where a harvester's parked, I'm going to plant that whole thing with trees. Firstly, just to see how long they take to grow, and secondly, they could make us a fair bit of money, like from wood chips and stuff. So, oh yeah, it's flipping dark here, isn't it? Okay, up this way, I think. Yeah, oh jeez. I think this is the first time I've actually sold anything up here. Okay, let's just unload all that. Should be about 30 grand or something, yes, 20 grand. I would have worked out how much it would have been, but I'm a bit lazy today, so. Yeah, it's a shame I have to sort of do this at night time, eh? Okay, oh, 40,000, yeah, that's a good price. Okay, we'll get this guy, we'll grab his pallet fork. Yeah, it's just a shame I have to do all this at night time, eh? As well as me not being able to see you, I mean, it's going to be hard for you guys to see as well, right? this why I can't pick it up. Okay, mate. Right, we'll take this guy up to the sheep then. I think we can go this way. I guess I could wait till dawn, couldn't I? Maybe the price won't fall too much by then. Yeah, I might do that, because I don't want to do this in the dark. So yeah, cool. I'll bring you back in daylight, eh? So we'll see you soon. Okay, cool. Welcome back. Well, the price is starting to go down, so we'll probably have to get this done pretty quickly. Eh? Take our wall down. Now, hopefully I can do this without being so goofy. Because these forks are quite hard to use, eh? These pallet forks. They're quite awkward. See if I can sort of push it straight against the building. Oh, not really. Okay, I'll zoom out a bit. It probably doesn't matter if it's a little bit crooked on the trailer, does it? Because I guess we can always straighten it. Whoops, we'll always straighten it up later. You had to get up there, are you? Just hoping I can flip my tractor. I'll just put it there. That'll be right. Okay, get the other one. And hope like hell that when we drive over there, these things don't bloody fall off. That'd be stunk, wouldn't it? Oops. Whoa. Oh no. Whoa. Oh, cool. Okay. Get this last one on. I'll probably plop it where those straps are, I guess. Whoa. I think if we just put it down there. Whoa! Shit! That's not helping. Well, I guess we could just stick it on the side, couldn't we? Not from oops. See, I'm trying to hurry, so that's making me extra clumsy. Right, let's see if we can. Oops. Lift that up a bit. Just put it where the orange strap is, it should be right now. Hoping that one, that second from the right, doesn't fall off. This will go around the corners. Okay, just jump here for a second. And can I put the straps on here? Fasten tension belt, yes. Okay, cool. Can I put one on this side too? Yeah, I can. Oh, good. A little bit here. Yep. Put another one there just to be safe. I'll probably put another one there too. Okay, cool. Yeah, I don't think that's going to fall off, is it? Fingers crossed. Now that should be about 60 grand worth, eh? Oh, yeah. Okay, now what was it to... Oh, X to fold the trailer. Now we need to go to... the spinnery. Which is down there, okay. Just drive across this dude's field, it'll be alright. Yeah, sorry about crop damage, buddy. Oh yeah, look at that big stripe across this field. Now something this game should probably have, eh, is if you have crop destruction on, you should have to pay for that, I reckon. Eh? The same's fair, doesn't it? Now oh yeah, when we get there, we'll probably have to lift all these off the trailer too. Like, it probably won't just be able to park up and we'll suck them off automatically, you know. So I wonder how many pallets of seedlings we can get on here. I think each one has 20 trees inside it. So we'll probably have to almost fill up this whole trailer, I guess. Okay, now where do we have to... Okay, that yellow square. Okay, well, I'll just park here. Detach. Oh no, actually. Yep, okay. Take those tension belts off. I want to see if I can just push them over, right? It might be easier. Hope they don't mind the wall being all muddy and smelly. And just pushed it off there. I'll move this out of the way. And we'll just push them in. We'll just push them in that square. Oops. No, I actually do need my engine going. Now, I'll just quickly check the price again. 8,034. Okay, so we'll probably still make that price, eh? Oh, don't tell me they have to. Oh, see? Yep, they're taking one at a time here. Look. So that's 15,000 for one of those. That's pretty good, eh? But it did take bloody ages, eh, to get enough wool. These ones on too. It's gonna, oh yeah, see, it's taking one at a time. Nice. Now I guess I could buy more sheep, but no, I've got more interesting things to do with the money than sheep. Is it gonna take it from here? Yeah, it is, good. Now, I realise this probably isn't particularly realistic doing it this way, but I mean, it's still selling the bales. It's just about taking the last one. Now, how much do we make exactly from all that? Oh, you see how much the price is going down there. $63,000. Nice. Got 40 grand from that, so you're 100 grand up, and the day's barely started. Right, so we'll take this dude down and we'll go and buy some pallets of seeds, tree seeds, and we're gonna have to like get another tractor or get something to tow back the tree planter. I guess, yeah, we could reset a red tractor back, I guess. Oh, will it have the horsepower to pull it? Probably not. I'm not actually sure how much horsepower it needs. We'll at least buy these pallets now, because, oh yeah, we won't be able to plant that field until we've harvested it anyway. So I can wait for a little while. Yeah. And let's buy some pallets. We must all do this here. See, pallet saplings, $40 for 20 trees. That's a bit of a steal, isn't it? It's a pity I can't select, like, say, buy 10 at once or something, because I'm going to have to do it like one at a time like this, which is a bit of a pain. Well, that's alright. Yet, but we'll do like a couple more. that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Right, so we'll detach from that and we'll start loading these on this trailer. And once again, I won't make you watch me do all of this, because it will take a while for me to get all these on the trailer, probably 15 minutes or something, judging by how goofy you've been so far. I should be able to fit quite a few on, but oh, I'll only be able to stack them one high, won't I? I guess. That's a bit of a worry. That's alright. I might not even be able to fit all these on here. Let's go over this way a little bit. No, gonna need to come up a bit. Whoa. Yeah, get that on there. I think so. Yeah, sometimes it's hard to see, yeah, with the angles out here. I'm going to dump this. Gonna slide out from under there. Good, I can. Good. Alright then. Yeah, I'll pause it here while I load all these on, and I'll bring you back soon. Okay, cool. Welcome back. Managed to fit about 10 on there. Now, I'm not going to worry about sort of trying to squeeze some more on the back there, because yeah, it might go a bit goofy, like once the once I raise the ramp at the back, you see. So we'll go and actually, I was just thinking maybe I should take the truck down to deliver this to where we're going to need to plant them, but we'll need the pallet fork to to take them off the trailer again, because I'd like probably another couple of trailer loads worth of these right down there. So that's 200 trees. I wonder how much of the, maybe 200 trees on this trailer. So I wonder how much of that that new field we kind of nicked. I wonder how much that'll fill. I guess we'll find out, eh? After we harvest and stuff. Well, at least, probably dump these ones off down there or something. We'll park the trailer somewhere handy anyway. We'll park it behind that building. And then when, I guess this harvester up here is finished, I'll go and lease the planter. Cause, yeah, I don't think I'll buy one, because the trees probably take bloody ages to grow, eh? Just park around here somewhere, it'll be good. Dump that off the, oh no, hold on a minute, we'll take off the straps. We'll take this dude back. Alright then, yeah, I'll pause it here and I'll bring you back when that harvester's finished that field, and we'll get the tree planter and we'll make a start on that, eh? So cool, we'll see you soon. Okay, cool, welcome back. It's finally harvest time. Now notice the price for wheat is still okay. So when this dude has finished his harvest, we might as well take them down to Gomed Rajakas again. Now I've got, remember this dude down here, now he's gonna bring back the tree planter. We'll just lease it. So we'll only need, this will probably be a once-off sort of thing, one-off thing. Now we'll actually load it before we go. We'll fill it up with these saplings. I think it takes one pallet. Yeah, we'll come back and get these other ones eventually too. Yeah, I think we just have to sort of drive over top of it with this in the fork. Well, oh, we probably need to be attached to it, do we? probably do. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll get this guy. He should be able to attach to him, I think. Oops. Can you... No, we can't. I wonder, oh no, hold on, what I could do, get this dude out of the way for now, let's put him there, jump into this, and we'll put this on top, and then we'll attach him, we'll see what happens. Oh, see, oh yeah, I want to be able to put this on here and not drop it off the other side, eh? That'd be really stunk. Okay, our harvest is just a bit full. I'll just leave that there for a second and see what happens when we attach. Oh, I guess we can. Okay, we'll at least take this dude back anyway. See if we can get there without this thing falling off the back. Jeez, no, we probably won't be able to, will we? Refill tree planter? Oh, yep. Okay, nice. Okay, that dude's actually full, so we'll... Keep missing my truck, there it is. Then we can start that other dude planting on the other side, so that should be good. Yeah, I'm not sure how long it actually takes to grow the trees. I'm guessing quite a long time, maybe, in trees. This dude's full. I'll park him like down by the shed, because that's probably about where the harvester will finish. Now, yeah, I still don't know why the cars are stopping. You can't, well, they've actually despawned now, but they were stopping around about in the middle of the road there, where I think I dropped the log, and it kind of glitched through the world, or, you know, I can't see it anymore, but I had a good look around to see if I could pick it up and get it out of the way, but now something else I should test too is if I can just drive the tree planter like next to the trailer where the pallets are and see if that loads it like it does with the seed and the fertilizer too. That'll be handy if it works like that. Maybe I'll check it the first time it's empty. Okay, just leave this dude here and we'll get this guy. Bring them back and we'll start them planting trees. Actually, no, we'll swap it over to the other tractor, because this dude has the pallet fork. And the other dude does have enough horsepower to drag this thing, so should be alright, I think. So after this harvest, we should have enough money to buy that field there too. I think I'll just extend it so that's just one big massive field down there. I won't go across the road, but oh, where's this clown going? No, mate, you're fired. Yeah, this is why this field's a hassle. Like, sometimes this dude gets really confused at the end, though. He doesn't know like which way to go. See, he did this little bit here, then he turned around like he was going to do another bit. So we'll get him going there, and we'll see if we'll do the whole thing. Now he's going to try and turn around again. So what we'll do... We'll at least start him off a little bit. I'm not too worried about that, we'll put a little weight on the end here. Is he going to turn around for Hollow the Worker? No, he's not good. Or is he? No, he is. Alright, you're fired, eh? I'll have to do this myself then. Yeah, I'm not sure why he does that. It's probably because it's not supposed to be a field here. Maybe the game still considers there being trees here or something, or it's a bit goofy with that other field there, you know? I don't know. Maybe we should just save up and buy that field there. Another couple of harvests though, we should have enough to get it. I probably should come back and get that weight on that sword too. Well, we'll see if he can do it himself from here. No, he's not. What the hell are you doing, man? So I hope the tree planter doesn't come across the same sort of issue, you know? Yeah, it's going to be hassle if it is. Because I want it to be like quite nice, neat, straight rows of trees along here, rather than, you know, just trees all over the place, random what. Because like, once this is mature, I'll lease another wood chipper, like we did along that road there. Lease a wood chipper. Probably get some help into it too, and just chip all the trees, and I'll put down one of those heating plants down this end, so we can fill up the trailer and just like dump it off into the air. Like, I'll have to use a conveyor belt system, I guess, so the truck can just drive up, dump it, and the belts will just suck it up and dump it like, straight into the heating plant. I think that'll work. Yeah. It should work. Let's get this last little bit, won't take long. Then we'll set them up doing these fields here too, because that's canola, I think, and the price for that was actually pretty good. Yeah, it's going up quite a bit. Nice. So we've got 6 fields of canola at the moment. Should be a whole bunch of money. And I'll have to go get the truck in a second. Yeah, it's a pain. This field's been a bit of a pain, eh? I mean, like, I did make a few bit of money off it with the trees and the crops that I've taken off it, but yeah, it's like they're really confused about what happens at that end. This end down here, it's not too bad, eh? But that far end, eh? I mean, it's like they don't know what to do, they're all confused and stuff. It's a bit of a bugger, really. Get this last little bit, there's only a little bit left. Oh yeah, that's that bit where this one gets stuck. It's a bit hilly there, it's a bit hard to see, but yeah. Might be a little bit on the end, but oh, you might as well get this little bit here too, I guess. We'll take the truck down, because that price is falling out of the wheat. Should be a reasonable amount, eh? It'll make it worthwhile. Driving the truck down there. We'll put the pipe out. We'll turn this dude off. Get our truck. And before we drive down, we'll set him up on that other field. Got this one right there. Yeah, I think maybe I should just save up and get that field right there too. And then hopefully I shouldn't have the same issues at the end of the field again. Oh, I don't know. Because I guess eventually, like after my trees have grown, I could just make that just one huge field. Whoops. There we go. No, it's not. Okay, we might actually have to move the harvester a little bit. It might be easier. Except I'll just jump back in the truck again. There we go. Oh no, it doesn't want to. Yeah, it's weird. Sometimes these trailers don't always work like that, do they? Interesting. Quite a lot of the graphics I suppose in it. It's quite well done, isn't it? Right, let's open Pipe up. Start on this field here. Right, oops, we'll get this guy down to the to that mill now. We'll mark it on the map. Gomez Ridge Acres. We'll take him to the 827. That's a pretty good price for wheat, actually. And then we'll plant some trees. I do like how this game has like the green beacons for where you're taking your stuff. I like that. It's, it saves a bit of driving around, you know, driving around aimlessly. Oh yeah, we will have to take this guy back, because that harvester will get quite full quite quickly, I think, with the canola. So it seems to be a relatively high yield from canola. Like, it's not as much as wheat, or barley, or, you know. It's probably, yeah, I think you get more from soy than it goes canola. I think sunflowers are the least of those high value crops anyway. It might be the other way around, eh? But yeah. It's probably, I don't know, half the yield per hectare, I guess, is wheat and barley. Nearly 8,000, that was, oh jeez. Keep your eyes on the road. Yeah, nearly 8,000 from that. From that trailer load, or part trailer load, which is pretty good, eh? Which is pretty good. You're getting to the stage now where our harvests are about 100 grand, eh? Each time, rather than about like 20, eh? What when we started, which is good. Or 20 or 30, I guess. Now I suppose I know like which crops are more valuable and more worthwhile, you know? Like wheat and barley, yeah, and corn, yeah, they can be lucrative, but I think I'd rather just stick to the soybeans and canola, you know. Kind of forget about sunflower seeds for the moment, eh, because they're a low yield crop, and I need the header and the planter to do those, so we'll just park this dude over here somewhere. Hopefully he won't be in the way if he parks here. That should be right. Right. Let's go plant some trees finally. Actually, no, we're going to swap this dude over. So we'll take him down by the other tractor. I guess, he could just drop his pallet thing here, because that other tractor's actually got a, one of those arms on it, isn't it? A front loader. So you will do that. So we'll come around this side. Oh, that tractor might need to wait to use this planter anyway, so I think this dude. So come around here. Oops, it's all right. That one. I'll just raise it a little bit. Lower that. Oh, it's super slow, isn't it? Oh, see, because it kind of plows a little furrow behind it. That's cool. That's cool. Okay, right, can I hire a worker to do this? I can. Good. So that means I'll have... Oh, no, I don't want to put it there. Goof. And that dude's nearly got a full tank. Right, we'll set this dude up with another pallet. Jeez. A lot of things going on at once at the moment, isn't there? Got the harvester, got these two dudes trying to plant trees. I'll take my truck over in a second. Can I get it from... Oh, I can't. Okay, I'll drop that a little bit. I think we'll be good. Okay, that dude's tank's full. He's got 10 trees left, so oh, I might have actually bought too many trees. Alright, this dude we actually have to move. So I can get the truck on. Let's turn him off. Which place had the better price? Oh, looks like it's going to be the mill again. So it looks like we'll be filling up the train again, though. Now that dude... That dude's almost at the end. I wonder how many trees he's got left. I'll check that in a second. Tank is empty. Okay, yeah, we'll fill you up in a second, mate. See, I guess I'm almost at the stage where I could buy a second harvester. Probably need another harvester if we get another field, eh? Alright, get this dude out of the way. I'll just plop him over here for the moment. Get your harvester going. Get your pipe away. This dude down. Hopefully he can get this in there without bloody crashing or something. Or dropping it. Okay, yeah, so what I'll do this time is I think I'll just leave the pellet sort of close to the planter and see if he can actually just reload like he can with the seeds and things. So if I like put it there. What happens if I jump in here? I can. That's bloody handy. Oh, right. I can plant some more trees then. Okay, that dude's right, you can go and get another one. Nice. So probably, maybe I should just attach to the trailer. That'll probably be easier, wouldn't it? And just drive up next to him. Yeah, it's going to annoy me that one there is like off the field a little bit, but that's alright. So I could probably actually use the ute to do this, if it's powerful. Oh, it might not be powerful enough to pull this trailer properly. Okay, we'll put those on at least, so they don't fall off. Let's see how the score's going. He'll probably say he's finished in a second. I'll actually fire him and I'll get him to go from the other end. So that took 27 trees for that row. Well, I should bring him a bit closer so it's 26, so it leaves that one off the end. And I wonder how close I can go to those ones. So we probably actually bought too many trees. Too many saplings, but that's alright. I've got heaps of money, so it doesn't matter too much, I guess. See if we can get them in quite close to this one. Hopefully they'll all grow. Oh, no, don't stick one there. I think he did anyway. Alright. gets the harvester going. Get this dude ready to fill him up then. Now hopefully we can just take it off the back of the trailer like this so I can drive along beside him. Should be able to just unload. Or reload from the tractor at least. He's got four left. Oh, that's cool how the trees will disappear from the pillar block. Yep. Right, four left now, we get five before. So three left. So if we'll take those off. Will he take one automatically? Of course he doesn't. Right, so if we go in here, somewhere, this tractor. Oh cool, he can just take it off the trailer. Nice. That's a good thing to know. Oh good, so he should be on the right side for the trailer. Right, we'll put those dookie dookies back on. Move him out of the way a little bit and might start him on this next row. Okay, he's nearly full. Nice, I'm glad that works. He's got 17 trees left, so once he finishes this row, we'll take him back to that end again, I think. So he might be a bit goofy again, though, planting this end. So, yeah, there's quite a space between all these trees then. That'll be good, eh? We'll just be able to pretty much leave this quarry. Or leave this field to grow the trees, and we won't have to fluff around with it, eh? Although probably what I should have done first is planted grass on it, eh? But whatever. That's alright, that's alright. Okay, that dude's full. We'll just get ready to get him. He's probably not gonna use up all his trees on him. He's probably got another four to go or something. Probably could have squeezed these trees in a bit closer actually. It'll be alright. Could probably even plant more down there. Okay, you can stop there. I'll take him to... Oh, yeah. I'll take him down the other end again. I wonder if I can fill up while the straps are still on. Check that. No, we probably can't, can we? So if we go up there... Maybe it needs to be, probably needs to be empty to do that. Okay, we'll turn that dude off and we'll go and empty this. Okay, cool, yeah, I'll continue derping around like this, eh? And I'll bring you back, probably after the harvest, eh? So, yeah, we'll see you soon. Okay, cool, welcome back here. I've actually used up all those trees, all the tree pallets that I took down to that field, and we're probably only, three quarters through. So that's 11 pallets for 220 trees. So I think I might actually... Oh yeah, this dude's in the third to last field harvesting. The prices aren't really that good. So we might actually sit on them for the next round, I think. What I'm going to do is I might... Yeah. Should I buy some seed? 900. Might buy like two more of those. I think that should be alright, eh? You can see that dude's not really doing anything. Is he going to be on the right side? I think he do. Here's about, I think, 5 or 6% fall. Yeah, I think he'll be alright. Okay, we'll just leave him for the moment. Oops. And I'll load these on and I'll drive them back and I'll finish planting that that tree field. And of course my bloody pickup's in the way. Now what would be cool, you know, is if you drove your trailer to a certain area on this map, right, you buy your pellets and it loads them on automatically for you, you know. That'd be bloody handy, wouldn't it? Instead of having to fluff around like this, loading them on the back. But yeah, cool, I'll continue on with this, I'll keep doing the harvest, I'll keep planting that field with trees, and I'll bring you back soon. Okay, cool, welcome back here, I'll finish planting here. Now it's 16 pellets of trees, or 320 trees all up. Now I'm going to take this back, so we don't have to pay any more money for it. Wait, that actually took quite a while, eh? Probably, I don't know, half an hour or something. Or maybe a little bit more than that, because I keep having to babysit them at the end, then take them back and load them up and stuff. But one cool thing is I didn't actually have to use a pellet fork to load the planter. I could just drive up next to the trailer, or actually I drove the trailer next to it and jumped back in this dude and just pressed R to refill, and he filled up again and then he was on his way again. So that's kind of cool, eh? You know? So what I'm going to do now, I don't think I'll plant my fields again tonight, but I will extend two of them where we've cleared the trees out. And we'll probably sit on the crops we have until another harvest cycle, because the price for canola wasn't very good. Well, I've seen it go up to like 1600-1800 or something, and at the moment it's only like 1200. So we'll get rid of that. Jump out and we'll turn this. And we'll take this other dude back soon. Nice. So for the leasing, how much did that actually cost? Oh, about 2,000 to plant all those. And the pellets cost 640, so about 2,700 roughly, which is pretty good, eh? Because when we sell those trees, it should get us a lot more money than that. Probably, I don't know, 100 times that. But we will have to wait a long time probably for them to grow. But yeah, I think it'll be worth it, eh? Just turn that guy off, and we've got this guy. He's going to come back for the plow, and I'm going to extend these two fields here. We'll do it on that side too. We won't do it. We won't do it on the side of the road because the harvester might get a bit goofy, eh? Like he might drive over the other crops and destroy them a little bit. So we'll just do along that side, eh? Along by the road. I think it'll be right. Now, where did I leave my plow? I think it's up here somewhere. I hope it's up here somewhere. Might be parked sort of by that little fuel tanker. Eh? Oh yeah, there it is. Okay, cool. Oops. Spilt my milkshake. Okay, cool. Yeah, something I was thinking of doing as well is buying one of the fields that's really close to the sawmill and using that for forestry too. And planting a whole bunch of trees on there, and then we'll just have to pretty much drive across the road to drop the chips off. Now there's this one here which might be good, because you know it's just across the road and just go in there. That'd be pretty cool. Make it a hell of a lot easier, wouldn't it? And having to like have a big elaborate setup over here for the wood chips and stuff. Oh, I could probably extend this one too, but we won't do that yet because we've got to get rid of all these trees first. Now, I reckon we'll be able to get another couple of rows off that end and this side too. So we'll just come around a bit. We'll see if we can line it up with each of this. Did any of these fields actually need ploughing? No, good. Now, of course, we won't be able to go very close to that that lamp post. Was it Y to create fields? I think it was. Okay, yep. I think that's probably enough. Yeah, that harvest is probably actually almost finished, that field, eh? Might be quicker to lease a big tractor with a huge plough away to do this, but that'll cost a bit of money, eh, won't it? Once again, I'll come back with the roller and I'll tidy this up later, but I think this will be okay. Oh, see, so you're kind of missing a few spots here, isn't it? Yeah, it'll be alright. Just sort of come over this way, but oh, he's a bit crooked, isn't he? And he could go... You could extend it towards the road, but then I'm kind of worried, like, traffic's gonna get on the way. Just turn this guy off and we'll jump in the harvest and we'll get this pipe out, we'll empty him and we'll start him on the next field. I wonder if I can drive around this way and get it on. And then we'll try it. Ooh. Okay, cool. Cool. Turn the guy off from here. If I could be bothered, I'd probably put all my fields in forestry, because you do get quite a bit of money off it, but it is quite fiddly, right? It is quite fiddly to get the trees on the trucks, or into the chipper, or, you know. It does take a little while. Ooh, he's struggling to make that turn. We'll set him up on our last field, anyway. Yeah, cause it's going to take me a little while to extend those fields, and I really don't want to be harvesting at night time over the next crop cycle. But we'll start this dude off anyway. We'll just make sure, he needs to kind of overlap this way a little bit. I think that'll be good. Well, I'll go back to this dude. See if we can sort of square it up on this end too. I think that'll be good. Cool. All right then. I think that's probably a pretty good place to leave the episode, eh? I mean, like, we're pretty much done, eh? Pretty much done with the harvest now. I'm not going to sell what I've got because, like I said, the price is kind of rubbish at the moment, eh? $13.47. I've seen it go probably another couple hundred dollars more than that. So we'll sit on our canola. Now I've got, I think, a whole bunch waiting to be put on the train as well. I've actually got the train over here, so yeah, probably about 50,000 odd waiting at the station. So what I'll do is I'll extend this field here, I'll keep ploughing this, then I'll do the other field over there too, extend it in the same sort of way, and when we come back, probably be starting to, yeah, we'll be sowing these fields here. We might think about doing a job, eh, and maybe buy another field, maybe that one over there, or save up for that one. I'm not sure yet, but cool. See you next time, hey, thanks for watching.